Yeah, of course, I see they're changing a lot. And then also during the, a part of collecting the dancer to be coming to dance of my dance company, I have like 20 dancers. I help them, but I cannot help all dancers around me. It's so hard. And I give back to the community, as you say. So I have two types. The one I collect the dancers, they come to my dance studio, and then I teaching them. I become like a family together. We stay together. Sometimes it's not only dancing. Sometimes also we talk about the life. Sometimes we meeting together. We traveling together to go to see maybe the local tour. It's like that. But out of that, we have this back to the community. We have visiting every Sunday. Sometimes we go every Sunday to the to teaching to the orphans' place.
It's so great to meet you, Frank.
Yeah, me too.
Tell me, where are you based exactly?
I'm based in Tanzania.
Okay.
Arusha, Tanzania.
Yeah. And you've got this wonderful dance company.
Yes, Arusha Dance Company. It is my dance company.
And when did you start dancing? Did you start already as a child?
Yes, I started the dance already like a child, but a professional one, I started when I was finished the standard, O-level, like form four, before you go to five and six. But I was dancing when I was child, like I remember it is like five years old when I am.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So, and where did you do dancing? Did you do ballet lessons or where did you dance?
Yes, on that time I get the scholarship of performing art. There's a one company called Ibuka Dance. So we get the scholarship of dance there. So I learned the different kind of dancing, and then the lady who was a director, she was from Canada. Then she started here, like dance school in Tanzania, here in Arusha. So that's why I learned from there. I get the scholarship from there.
Okay. And then, so you did all different types of dancing?
Yes, I do.
The long-term benefits of sunscreen have been proved by scientists, whereas the rest of my advice has no basis more reliable than my own meandering experience. I will dispense this advice now. Enjoy the power and beauty of your youth. Oh, never mind. You will not understand the power and beauty of your youth until they've faded. But trust me, in 20 years, you'll look back at photos of yourself, recall in a way you can't grasp now how much possibility lay before you and how fabulous you really looked. You are not as fat as you imagine.
And when did you start your dance company?
Don't worry about the future.
My dance company, I started, it was the end of the 2018.
Okay.
Yes.
Why did you want to start the company?
For sure, I love dance. And then also where I came from to the normal family, like poor family, so I could not afford anything on time. And also I was using the dancing like a part of my life to save my life. So during I get the dance of the scholarship to that Ibuka Dance Foundation, so they teach me. After the end of the day, when I finish the diploma of performing art, I start to work to the East Africa, like outside of Tanzania. And then after that, I meet a lot of the people, especially the dancers from the street, from the community. And then I feel like to help more dancers like where I came from. So I think so it would be helpful for them, and then they can achieve their goal through the dance, or also they can live. If you focus, they can go through their own life about the dancing. So then I decided to go to the government and then to take the letter and then to start to open the dance company, so to help the dancers from the community. So the aim is to supporting them, that it is, it impressed me a lot to do that dance company. Yeah, I know that she is waiting. Oh,
I'm alive. And that's what I... Yeah, and you said now that the dance actually saved your life. In what sense did that help you in your life?
Yeah, I think so. I could not have any kind of job. So when I was in the home, finished the study. Because I growing up with my daddy, not my mom. But I know my mom when I was a bit young. I mean, older, like 13 young. Yeah, like 13, I know my mom, but they could not live together. But during I was staying with my father, yeah, my father was a little bit like a businessman, so I can get what I want sometimes, you know, it's like care. Yeah. But after my father passed away when I was 13 years old, and the relative of my father, they say, you have your mom in Tanzania, the whole time I was living in Congo. So, and then after that, I come to Tanzania, I see my mom. But my mom was the life for her. It was a little bit hard, difficult to also sometimes to afford the meals per day. It's so hard. So we eat once, sometimes we are not eat. So during I using the dancing, and then I dance to the place like to the wedding sometime, yeah, to the wedding, to the small part in the street where I was stay. So it get and give me some money to achieve this, so that I can say the dance, it's helped me a lot through to my life. Yeah.
So, and you so that, and it actually helped you also because you did the dance lessons before when you were younger.
Yeah, when I am younger, I could not do in the dance before. The dance before I was growing up, I loved dancing. I was danced by myself. But in a professional way, like after I finished to study like O level. So that's why I get the chance to go to study there. That I become professional. But before I was unprofessional, I was dancing like straight in dance, the traditional things. Like Lingala, like normal dancing, like every people can dance. You know, if you hear the music, the rhythm is coming automatically. So, but I was have that talent, but I can dance. And then also in the street, that times I was try to watch to the television, because I could not have the phone. So television with the neighbors' places, they have a television. Us, we don't have a television. So we go and then we watch some CDs. Through that, I was dancing. I was see the steps, and then I teach by my other.
Wow.
My yes, that it is. I growing up, I just watch and then I teach my friend. And then the end of the day, people, they invite us to the party and then we go to dance there. They give us something. That it was the life of me. Yeah.
But it's wonderful that you have that so naturally. So that's your talent. You just wanted to dance when you were younger.
Yeah. That it is. It's just coming automatically. And then now in professionals, it's like you wanna be professional, you wanna be international dancer, you need to study. So that's why I just get the scholarship on that, and then I study in 7 years. Yeah, 7 years. To masters everything like ballet, contemporary. It was, for me, it was something new, like ballet, contemporary. I was asking by myself, what is that? Yeah, but African dance is okay because it's kind of African traditional dance, how the way they dance, they combine, they put together. And then we have this traditional dance through our culture, for example, like Chaga, Pare, Maasai, so those kind of these things. So they're mixing together. But the all I studied there is like salsa, Afro contemporary and hip hop, and also bachata, kizomba, tango. So those kind of those things I studied from there, and then now it's like I achieve. So it's like they praise me a lot after I finish my study. And then I get some different kind of the people. They just called me to go to do the workshop, for example, in Kenya, Uganda, Rwanda. Yeah, it's like that, Burundi. So that it is, I traveling a bit through my talent. And yeah.
That's amazing. But do you do also now the traditional dance and the, say, the other dance forms that you learn? Do you mix all the dances now together?
No, I'm not mixing the dance together. I studied all different kind of dancing, but I have some schedules. So some people, they call you, they say, okay, you guys, we need you to come to perform only contemporary. So you just do contemporary. So it's like that. We need you to come to perform salsa. So we do salsa. Hey, guys, we have a wedding. So please, can you teaching us tango? So we go. I teach them tango. So we are not combined together. It's like each have their different form of how we're supposed to dance. So it's that it is I use through from that.
Now, I've seen on Instagram amazing work that you're doing. Really? I mean, these classes, these dancers look amazing. So they were all trained by you?
Yes, they are all, I training them. They come in there, they don't know anything. And then I am the one who training them until they are now there, how they are. So now they can train by themselves. If I have kind of, because we have like an international school here, they're calling us to go to teaching. So they get a little bit some income through that. So they, I go together with them. First of all, they see what teaching, because now they are good dancer. They know how to dance, but you can be the good dancer and then you don't know how to teach, right? So go with them. I go with them and then and they see me. It's like assistants. They see me what I'm teaching. And then at the end of the day, I try to say like, okay, today, can you go alone to teach? So they become like that, rising up themselves. But we get payment and then also I pay them. So that is could be the part of their life. So I teaching them from the beginning. So most of the dancers, they come there, they don't know even how to dance, but they say, I love to dance, but I don't know how to dance. So I start again from the beginning, I teaching them. And then it's I put something this like 2 years, 1 year you get certificate, then 3 years you get diploma because I am registered a company. And it helped me a lot. But they study there for free because they come to the poor family, like local family. The thing it's helped me to rising up the money is the schools I teach and the performance I get. And then some of the workshop or some of the private classes, some people I get the group of visitor, they come from outside of Africa. They say we want to learn African dance, like workshop. I teaching them, I go some with the dancers, they do performance, we get money. So that it is, I just using that money to growing up the company. Nobody support, but I use the way how I do. So I use a lot of money to give them the dancers to teaching them. And then also it is, it helped me like that for the dance company to rising up. So people to understand what I'm doing. Yeah, that it is I'm doing.
People, I mean, there are a lot of poverty, so the children don't have money to to pay for lessons. So do you help also in the community to get the children to get to come to dance, and so that they are, you know, that they can do something else, or that they can lift themselves out of the poor conditions that they live?
Yes, of course, yes. I can say yes, because the poverty in Africa, I think so, this is normal. Some people, they have money. Some people, they are rich. Some people, they are not rich. But let's say in 7% of African people, they have a normal life. They can have 1 meal per day. They can have 2 meal per day. And then most of the people, they don't have meal per day, because it's so hard how to find a job. It's so hard how to raising up the kids. If you have the kids, most of them, they get supporting through the government. We have a lot of orphanages areas or centers. Sometimes there is a volunteering come to volunteer that they help them like that, through like that. But it's not all the people, they are poverty. No, it depends on the people, because our life here, it's very difficult. If you travel to Africa, you can see what I mean, how it's difficult. And then also, we have our normal meals. We don't have this competition. We don't have competition of life, for example. We don't have everywhere you can get Wi-Fi. It's not like that. Everything is here, is you need to work hard. There is no way government can help you for free or what. So you need to work for that to get them, to get yourself. So if you cannot work, you cannot eat. So most of the people, sometimes they do that, but most of the people, if they don't get the job here, they become like go around and then to ask you for help. So it's like that. But this is normal life. I know it's everywhere, but the difference between the Africa and the outside of the Africa, it is like outside of the Africa, you can get a bit supporting with your government also, but here you cannot get that support with the government. You need to work by yourself. And also here, the population of the people, sometimes normal families, they have 6 kids, 10 kids, 12 kids, you know, and then also the income is very low. So, for example, here, you can work per day, you can get like, for the normal people who work, you can get like, let's say, if normal job, you can get some people who helping to the normal hotels, they get 2,000 per day. So that's 2,000, it is almost like $1. So $1 you get per day, and then you have a families. So how are you going to go to feed the family for that? That it is, I mean, because to get money also, our value of money is very, very low. And then you guys, the value of your money is very high. You can come, for example, I can say the normal people who stay, who live in Europe or who living in outside of Africa, when the normal people, they come here, if they come here, they look as they're rich, because the money have a value, you know. So those kind of those things for us, it is like a little bit of challenges to rising up. And then it's so hard to get a job here. So if you're not studied as enough, you cannot get a job properly in the government. So you can be at a home, you need to find how you're supposed to do. So maybe you can do the small job for the people, cutting the fence, maybe. Those kind of it's not easy to get. Or sometimes you need to open your own business, but the only business to the street is only to sell the granite, sell sweets, to go around like that. So it's so hard for that. So most of the people I take them, or I just help them through the dancing. They come for those families. Sometimes they are not afford like that. It's so hard. Even sometimes they cannot buy themselves like shoes, also like t-shirts they wear, you know. So that it is, I mean. So for me, if I put there, if I tell them to pay me even 1,000 per day, 1,000, it is like, I can say it is like half dollar. So half dollar, they cannot give me that half dollar. They don't have money. So they come to my dance company also. I afforded them to give them transportation. But before that, when I started that, I could not have the money also to go to the studying like that. But now I get this opportunity, I need to help them. And then what I help them through the art, through the dancing, is the what I'm teaching sometimes. I have a lot of the private now money to teach some people yoga. I study yoga and diploma. Like I have 4 international certificate. So I teach it. So the money I get, for example, is good because I teach morning. So if I get a group of people, sometimes they pay 1 people, they pay like 15,000 per 1 hour. Even the dance is 20. So 20 is $10, and then that is good, so I can afford. And then I stay, I rent, I need to eat, you know, I need to take care of the dogs, you know, those kind of things. I need to take care of my bills. I need to buy the electricity. I need to do what? I need to pay the dance studio there. You know, I need to pay the dancers. They come every day. I need to support them, transportations. So those kind of, this is a lot of challenges. But as long as I get this opportunity to teach, that's why I focus that much to teaching a lot of people. And then the dance school, we are everywhere there. So we hire the studio from 10 up to 5 p.m. So we have that schedule from like Monday. Today, we're going to go to dance, maybe let's say contemporary African dance and then Afro. So we have like coming the foreigners. They want to come, the volunteering to join our classes through with the dancers. They are paid. They pay 20, but the dancers, they are not pay anything. Okay. So through that, we get the money. So we're supporting them. That the money I get there also, it's helped me to pay them transportation. Also, it's helped me to pay also sometimes the studio, because it's very expensive. If people, they see you dance, it's like, wow, you have a lot of money, but it's not like that. But arts, I know. And then, but it is a lot of struggling, how about challenges like that? So that it is, I decided to be like that in my life, to be like that. But I need to achieve more and more. And then also, I never stop planning. So every day I'm just having classes by myself. Every day I'm just trying to join some different workshops. Now it is I starting the program to give the dancers every Saturday to teach the workshop so they can raising up or to achieve their skills through that.
But this is wonderful that you do that and that you are so giving back to the community. And can you see for children, for example, or the dancers, can you see how that changed their lives?
Yeah, of course, I see they're changing a lot. And then also during the a part of collecting the dancer to be coming to dance of my dance company, I have like 20 dancers. I help them, but I cannot help all dancers around me. It's so hard. And I give back to the community, as you say. So I have 2 types. The one I collect the dancers, they come to my dance studio, and then I teaching them. I become like a family together. We stay together. Sometimes it's not only dancing. Sometimes also we talk about the life. Sometimes we meeting together. We traveling together to go to see maybe the local tour. It's like that. But out of that, we have this back to the community. We have visiting every Sunday. Sometimes we go every Sunday to the to teaching to the orphans place. So we teaching them. Wow, so that is for free. So that it is, we do them for free. So we using our transportation to be there, we teaching them for free. And then we have this kind every Tuesday. We have a program where we receive the disabilities kids. They come to the dance studio. We're teaching them for free. But this one I could not publish because you understand. So sometimes I put only on my status like that. It's not that in deep. So through that, I give back to the community in 3 ways. So once I start, I collect the dancers and I help them. But the end of the day, if they feel that, I'm so glad because now I release some dancers. They finished diploma. Now they are out. They are out of Tanzania. And then they work there. They enjoy it, their life. But It's not everybody can come, they can become like you. Everybody find their own way to stay. So I'm glad that is the one. Then the second thing, it is this, we do kind of giving back to the community while we go to the different orphanages and we teaching them for free. And then the third one is this, we give the chance of people who have a liability or disabilities to come to our dance studio and then we teach them for free. Mm-hmm. That it is, yeah.
That is so amazing. I mean, this is so great that you do that and that you thought of doing that, because dance and all forms of art, it's so uplifting for people.
Yeah.
Mm. And so, it brings joy. Yeah.
Yeah, a lot. Joy, happiness, peaceful, calmness. So it's a lot. Sometimes I teach, sometimes it's not I do teaching the children or they come to teach the children who have a liability or disabilities together to my dance studio. Sometimes I travel out of Tanzania. I was in Zambia teaching the 300 kids who have a disabilities. I stay there. I use my transportation. I stay there. I help them. I teaching also sometimes Swahili, our language, because Africa now, the Swahili has become like national language now.
Really? So
Yeah. So it's like I'm teaching them Swahili. I be with them. I draw them together. I put the dance. Some people, they don't have arms, but they can dance. And most of people, they have this problem on the brain. So they're all the time like, so it's hard. Sometimes people, the children, they can shit themselves from nowhere. So like that. So I will stay there almost with them like 3 weeks, and in the end I leave, there was cry all the time. They say, when you come back, we never find people like you bring us the joy here. And the owner also, she has a disabilities, and then also the assistant has also disabilities. So it was nice for me, and then also it was good, even if I use my money, so it's good to my heart, it's feeling like that. Nobody give you money, say, okay, can you go there? No, because it's so hard to get the support, maybe until people who have, they see it, what you are doing in deeply, they can say that. But when I post it to the Instagram, most of the people, they see like it's a big company, maybe some, this guy is rich, so it's kind of like that. But here it's totally different. I'm struggling a lot. Sometimes I'm not eating by myself. I didn't get the money also per day sometimes. I cannot afford my meal sometimes. I cannot afford three times like breakfast and lunch and supper. I cannot afford sometimes only breakfast and then it's zip like that. It's not all the time I can. But thank you, God, as much as I get my money for rent, I get my money for eating even a bit, or I get the money for pay this dance studio. It's a good. But now how I can go out of this, my aim is like, until when you can save the money, you can have your own space and start building the dance. It's so hard here. So everything to buy, the land is very expensive. It's not easy to buy here. If you don't have a good connection, you cannot get any connection with the people. So, but we try, I try by my best to work with a different company. But the thing is, they company we work with them, it is like that what they need, for example, to do the performance for their event, and then the end of the day, if you're done with them, the performance will go like that until okay. They have a call you like that. But nobody, people say, oh, we will support you, or sometimes we get a company, they say, want to work with you, we'll support you, say yes, no problem, we work with them even for free, they're giving a little bit amount of money, you pay the dancers, the money is finished. The end of the day, when they are finished their own things, they stay calm, they stay quiet, even not calling you, not send you a message again. So this is it's kind of a little bit painful, because you use a lot of energy, you make somebody events become good, some company become good, and then the end of the day they leave you like that. And it's not everything, it's not for money. Sometimes you try to do this for free. And then also sometimes I do a lot of, sometimes I do event by myself, like Arusha Dance, we have events, and then the people, they come, they pay the entry. But the entry is not enough even to pay the dancers. So I need to find another extra money by myself to my pocket. So I make sure that after the dancers, they finish to perform, I can give them, I think I can miss their money for eating. And then the losses stay on my heart, and I keep moving. That it is something.
I mean, you train the dancers, you do the choreography, you do all the work yourself, and so you know that is that you feel when you go to an event and you do the performance, you want to get the money for it.
Of course, yes. That it is. But most of the people here, they are not serious. They are not taking the dancing as serious things. Before, in our culture, they was taking, if you do the dancing, it's look like bad manner. So that it is. Yes. Mm-hmm. It's not take serious like outside the country. If you dance here, even now, most of the people now, they're not educated. They see that dancing is not a job. It's something else. Like joy is joyful, and then it's nothing. You are nothing. You get from dancing. Why you want to become the dancers? Why you want to become the dancers? I think so because of the people, how they take reaction of the dancing. I don't know how it is the background before. Because dance is like ceremony. But the people dancing, for me, I understand dance is everything if you take serious.
Yeah.
And it will take you far away if you focus. A lot of the family, the children, they want to dance, and then mama say, "Mama, I want to dance. Daddy, I want to dance. Don't dance. Go to study, because dance is nothing. How you wanna go to dance? Yeah. What did you get from the dance? This is like prostitute things. So it's so hard. It's so hard. But now people, they start to understand a little bit, step by step. But it take time. Mm-hmm. It take time. We don't have a lot of dance company here. In Arusha now, I can say in Arusha we have the small groups of dancing, but the dance companies, I can say I am alone. In Dar es Salaam there is a few, but in Arusha, like dance company really, is I am alone, maybe two, yeah, something like that. The other one is the small group. They do like street. They go to the club. They do performance. That. They get a few money, they go back home. But it's not help. But now it's like I make the dance company and seriousness, and then typing, and then I have a page is nice, and then I write, I try to make it arrangement. Now people, they say, wow, this is serious. So we get sometimes the children, they come every Saturday, we teach them ballet, so we get money. So now people, they say, wow, this is good. But not everybody bring the children. Sometimes people, they come, they bring the children, they say, wow, we were thought that is free.
Okay.
Just children, they can dance, then they can go home. Mm-hmm. Say, no, but it's not for free. So you need it too. Now it's at least starting to showing the respect.
Yeah. And I think also, you know, the children that do this, that dance now and do the ballet, when they grow up, they will also understand the value of it.
Yeah, they understand. They understand. They get used to it. Now it's most of the children here we get. It's like, wow, the parent, they say, wow, my daughter, she was always work on the toes. She do like this. She look in the cartoon to the TV, and then we was wondering, what is this kind of dance? I say, ballet. Whoa. Okay, she loved that. You can see. And then my one of the other children, I was look at him all the time. He tried to do the circus, or see like that. What is this? I say, oh, gymnastic. Wow, do you have gymnastic? Yeah, kind of that. They're starting to improve.
Amazing. But now, Frank, tell me, what are the wishes for you for the future? What would you see happening for your dance company?
My wish for the future, it is to help more people, more dancers as much as I wish. And but the big wishes is like, if I can get like supporting, I know until now what I'm doing is it's an amazing step. And I'm trying to find to focus that much more. It's so hard and difficult for me because I am growing up now. I would love to have a family. You know, I don't have a family, so I would have to have the family. That's kind. And then if you have the family, you need to work extra. To work extra for the family, for the company, for the people who behind you, and then for the old project. But my wish, it is the first of all, is like, if I can I can find people or maybe people who can support to one step, not like 100%, even like 10% or 20%, like to have the place where it is permanent that I cannot pay anything. So like even it could be far from the town, it's okay. But if you're building nice and then people they understand is the place for the it's theater is very good for the people to be there and then to have a nice dance theater and a small studio like that. That is okay. And then also to have like van, the small van for collecting the dancers from the town to bring there, that is could be helpful. That is my wish, what I was wishing for every time on my brain. And I'm thinking about that, what I'm going to go to do it during. I think so that it is my big wish. And if I could have that, I'm sure I can push by myself to become more big and international. So I can invite some dancers from the outside of the country and they can come or some teachers to come to teaching us. Even if it would be good to afford it or to afford them some money or maybe they can come to volunteering, but you can afford them some accommodation to stay, something like that. I get some messages to my page, some dancers, they want to come to volunteering, but they say, oh, you need to pay the transportation to come there or to do accommodation for us. It's so hard. And I'm trying to explain it about what I'm going through with that. And then they were not like saying, what? Oh, but it look like you work so hard much. Look like you have money. You look like that. I say, no, this is what I do. Sometimes I do like karma. So it's not all the time. It's like you see some people, you see like sometime we do workshop for free. So if we do for workshop for free, as you see all the time in Instagram, when we post some dance workshop, we free. Even you put $50 people to come to Inter to pay you 1,000, it's so hard. So if it's so hard, think that we're going to go to afford it to pay like 5,000, that is $2. To come to a workshop, it's hard. You need to become famous, really famous. That's why I do a lot of free, I traveling a lot by using my money to find a good connection to the different country, to teach them for free, to make a good arrangement first. So later, if people they can start, well, I know this guy, yeah, it's good, yeah, I like that. At least the people start to pay something. But here is they look like, if you're very famous, you need to have a number of followers to the Instagram, you can get money. And then now if you travel everywhere, you can just say you have dance, you have workshop, people they can come because they know you're famous. But for big times, it's quiet, different. So that it is, and my wish is like that.
So you would like also teachers to volunteer to come to teach there from the outside?
Yes, I love a lot. As long as if it could be far away from Africa, as long as I can get maybe transportation, like to go and to teach, go and return and accommodation without getting any payment, I'm okay with that.
Okay. You would like to teach outside as well?
I love a lot. But the thing is, I cannot go outside from here. Yes, I have passport. I have the passport. I travel with that card. And then it is international passport. So I'd love to go to teaching, even for free. But if I can get, like, to show the people what I have, you know, it's like that. I know if I go once, maybe next time they can see what I'm doing, they can just put something. Cannot go for free anymore again. Maybe they can pay me everything, but they can say, wow, we give you this like $300, you can go with that, no problem. Or $500, you can come back with the happiness because you share outside of the country and then you share what you have, for example, in natural, like African dance, African contemporary. I know there they have modern dance. I do modern dance, but I cannot teach modern dance there because that is a normal routine for them. Yeah. I can teach them temporary, like African contemporary, how it's look like. I can teach them the African dance, how the culture of African it's look like. that is the new things, and the people that can be happy, and then also they can want more to feed what you have, because it is new style for them. So that's it, I believe, for that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that will also help you then when you come back to, you know, to help the community and to help, you know, build your school and your company.
Yeah, it will be help. Now people, they can see that, wow, you are more international now. Because now you are here, you are international, but now people, they go, yes, you are a professional dancer, but you need to be like international, you know, like international professional dancer. Now it's like, I am professional dancer. Yes, I am professional. But most of the people, they ask me some question, why you're not traveling outside of Africa? You know, you can do dance workshop there, we can see. Because now I have a good cloud for the Instagram. So if I can travel, people, they can see, wow, so this it is. When you come back, you become now ready. You wasn't professional. It's come like a professional international, you know. So it's, you add more. But now it's like, I am professional. Yes, I am international. But people, they believe here, if you become to be international, you need to travel over the world, you know. Even you can go out of Africa, that you can become like, yes, this is professional international, you know. I am professional international, but in an African way. But if I go like outside of Africa, I could come like, I am professional international. I can go there and then do the workshop, stay 1 week, it's okay. But the one I do workshop is good. I get the people, even if for free, it's okay. But I come back here, I post, I just give back to the Instagram and post, and then people, they see, wow, you are traveling, but you do something better, you know, and then people appreciate, become more.
Well, Frank, I think you have to come and teach here, in Europe and or in the United States, and they have to pay you so that because you deserve that. So I wish for you really that you get invited and that. You know, you can do the workshops and bring your dancing to the communities here as well, you know, to the dance companies here. And because you're doing amazing things. I follow you on Instagram. I'm really so impressed with what you're doing and the standard. And
thank you so much.
It's amazing.
Let's see how it will be.
Yeah.
Sometime in hope, never lose hope. Still there in the hope.
Fingers crossed.
So it's like that. And let's see how it will be.
Yeah.
I believe. Still have the time. Maybe the time it's not yet, but it will be.
It will be. I believe with you.
Yeah. Yes. And I will fly. Because the stars are always calling my love. Yeah, I know that she is waiting. Oh, I'm alive. And that's what I'm living for. We'll be right back.
didn't stay in America.